Hello, I'm Marta, and this is the 8th episode about the rebuild of my DR350S. The last time, when I was trying to start the engine, I've discovered there is no spark. This is the last episode about the spark issue. The only thing left to check is the CDI unit. First, let's see all the connections leading to the CDI on the wiring diagram. Starting from the leftmost side, first is the output for the neutral indicator light. It's the blue with the black tracer cable. Closest to it is the blue cable leading to the neutral indicator switch. To start the engine, it should be grounded. Next is the green wire. It provides signal from the side stand switch. This signal doesn't matter in the engine startup. Neighboring wire is the white with the red tracer tachometer signal cable. All those cables are located in the one 4-pin connector. The ignition coil is connected to the CDI unit by the white with the blue tracer cable. The CDI is grounded by the black with the white tracer cable. The last one in the 3-pin connector is the black with the yellow tracer cable. It leads to the ignition switch and the engine kill switch. Those three wires are important and should be checked carefully. Next, gray and yellow cables are connecting the CDI with the pickup coil. The brown and the white cables are leading to the power source coil, which powers up the CDI unit. It is connected by two bullet connectors. The blue and the green cables are connecting the CDI unit to the second pickup coil. Both pickup coils are connected by the same 4-pin connector. It is also important to check the ground connections from the battery to the ignition coil and to the CDI unit. So first, I'm checking connection between the battery negative terminal and the CDI ground connector. As you can see, it's okay. In the same way, you can check the ignition coil grounding. Just unplug this connector and connect to the black wire with the white tracer. Next, I'm checking connection between the CDI and the ignition coil. It's the white with the blue tracer cable. I connect the multimeter to the flat connector of the ignition coil and the CDI 3-pin connector. There is also no problem. In the last videos, I've already shown how to check neutral gear indicator, kill and ignition switches, pickup coils and power source coil. For tests of those, see links in the description. So, as everything is okay, the last thing to check is the CDI unit. I've tested the CDI with the ohmometer according to the resistance table in the Suzuki service manual at chapter 12, page 22. For example, let's make a test for the blue and the green cables. According to the resistance table, I'm connecting the positive probe to the green wire and the negative probe to the blue wire. As you can see, the value is in range. There is also tests for the inverted connection for those wires, so you've got to watch out to not read the wrong table cell. I found a lot of errors in this table, so I concluded my CDI is defective and I bought a used one on eBay for 70 euro. Out of curiosity, after receiving my new CDI, I've also measured it according to the resistance table. I was very disappointed because I've noticed the same errors. Nevertheless, I mounted it to the bike and was surprised as the spark was back again. It seems that resistance test is not enough to know if the CDI is working or not. There is possibility that the resistance table in the manual has some errors, or possibility that I saw the errors because I was not using the recommended Suzuki tester. But for me it's just an ohmometer, so it shouldn't matter. Anyway, I'm super happy for the spark return. Hopefully DR will run now and the engine hasn't got any more diseases, for which I will look in the next episode. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed, leave a like and stay tuned for the next videos documenting DR rebuilding.